Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I know I've been MIA, I've been a little unwell, but I'm back here. I'm back to do a series. So I'll be posting back to back for 9 days. So I'm gonna do a Navratri series. So stay tuned for that. So today's video is going to be about beginner's makeup, a complete guide for beginners. So if my hair looks different, yes, I did get a haircut. If you don't follow me on Instagram, you can follow me there. I'll give you like more of the updates there. It's a little fun time. I've been inactive, but I'll be back there. So I wanted this video to be like, I am a person who doesn't know anything about makeup. Like when I started out, I had no idea about makeup. So if there is one video I could see, like where I know what all products are actually there for doing makeup, what to use where, how to use, what colors to choose, what is good for with skin type, everything related to that. So if all those videos combined were in one video, it would have been really, really helpful. So today I'm going to try and do that. I think I did a good job in noting down all the points. If I miss a few, please like know that it was not intentional. And I'll also link all the videos which you can see if you're a beginner to help you guide through makeup. This is basically a guide of what a product is, how to choose, etc. The techniques and everything obviously will be a separate video. So I'll add videos whichever I like did already so that you can check them out. So I think this video is going to be really long. So I'm going to do part one and part two. So let's get started. So I took one product and divided like various categories, types and etc. So you're going to have various different categories. So for example, let's take foundation. You're going to have categories of coverage, of finish, of type and what skin type, you know, various different things. So I've categorized everything according to that. Now let's start off with primer. So what exactly is a primer? A primer is basically something which helps your makeup to go on very smoothly onto your skin. So there's no one particular type of primer. There are various different types of primers. Primer is where your makeup process starts. So that doesn't mean you avoid your skincare. You need to properly hydrate with serums, with moisturization. You need to hydrate your face really, really well. And then for your makeup, before going in with your makeup, like foundation, etc., you've got to add a primer. So a primer can be various different types. So there can be a pore filling primer, a hydrating one, a illuminating one, and like basic, you know, skin prep mist as well. So for like basically a pore filling one, they're usually very silicone-y, they're like clear, they are very like thick in consistency. Like this one from the Lakme gel primer. So basically this is a pore filling primer. It's very jelly. It's supposed to go into the pores and fill it, and so that you have a very even application of foundation and your face doesn't like, you know, seem like very too many pores. I can't talk. So anyway, so this is one type of primer and it's usually given, like used to fill out the pores before applying makeup. Now the second type is primer water. So this is the Smashbox primer water. You just spritz this on your face before going in with your makeup. It basically just hydrates your skin. Like if you actually applied your moisturizer maybe two hours ago before like you go in with your makeup, this is like really nice to just, you know, add that hydration and nourishment back to the skin. So this is something really quick and easy to do, like this one or MAC Prep and Prime. These are like just primer waters which will help on easy application for your foundation without having any dry patches or anything on the skin. Now next one is a illuminating one. So this one is from Becca. Like the MAC Strobe Cream is also a very illuminating primer. So you go in with that if you want like any like really shiny glowy type of makeup. Although I would avoid if you have like textured skin or you have like too many pores, too many acne bumps or any texture, then you'll have to avoid it. So this is a like illuminating one. So this is very, very glowy, very, very nice. You can add it on high points of your face if you have oily skin so that you just get that shine on the high points of the face like I did. Or you can just like, you know, add this on the entire face if you have dry skin and you want like a glow on the entire face. So the next type of primer is just basically a very, very like what you call a nourishment type of primer. Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base is like that type of primer. It has shea butter, etc. So basically just moisture. Moisturize your skin really, really well, hydrates it so that whatever you apply later looks really beautiful. Now these three types don't fill your pores as much according according to me, like a silicone, like a very thick, like the Lakme one does. So this thing goes in and fills the pores and creates like a layer on the pores too, so that when you apply foundation, it looks nicely. But these are something which just hydrate and make your skin really smoother, but don't fill the pores completely like the other one does. But I really usually go in with such things because I like the way it feels. Silicone primer sometimes can get really heavy because it, you know, sits on your pores. If you get oily, it kind of gets a little messy. So it depends on your choice. If you have really oily skin, then you can even powder your skin before going in with makeup to stop the oil. I'll put a video here where you can see about that. Those are the four types of primers: pore filling, hydrating, mist, and an illuminating one. Now moving on to foundations. Now foundations, where there are various different categories. So they're like coverage and there's finish and there's type. So in coverage, so there's sheer coverage, there's medium coverage, and there's full coverage. So sheer coverage is basically something, a product which doesn't have a lot of coverage. How do you say, it doesn't, if you have like a mark, it doesn't totally cover it, it just blurs it out and gives you a very like skin is peeping through type of finish. So even if you add a lot of product for that, you would not get full coverage. You would like get a very nice skin like feel with a sheer coverage product. I put a dot on my finger and swatch a sheer, medium, and full coverage so that you understand the meaning of how they blend out and how the mark is getting covered. Now the second one is medium coverage. So medium coverage is ideally something which I usually go for. I like medium coverage, medium to full coverage type of foundation. So basically they kind of mostly cover all the scars, unless you have like really like pigmented like acne scars or pigmented skin, but usually medium coverage foundations are really good. They do the job, they cover everything up really well. It's like a proper good glam. It does feel like a little like makeup, but it looks really beautiful. Now the last type is full coverage foundation. So full coverage is like, it can cover entire like everything on your face, any mark, any blemish. But mostly full coverage foundations do look a little heavy. They don't look natural, they don't look like makeup, you know. Literally like even sheer coverage foundation, mostly anything, when you're putting a product, it does look like a product. Your job is to make it look as less heavy and cakey as possible. So there are three types of in coverage: sheer, medium, and full. So next there's a category of finishes. So finishes as in how the foundation looks after you apply. So there's three types. One is dewy or illuminating foundation, the second one is demi matte, and the third one is matte. So I personally prefer a demi matte, even if you're for dry skin or oily skin, because it looks really beautiful, doesn't look really dry or doesn't look really oily. But dewy foundation are really good for dry skin people if you want to try. So basically dewy skin foundation give you a lot of glow. They are not as matte, they give a lot of shine. You can tone them down using a powder, but those foundations usually tend to get oily really quicker compared to a matte or a demi matte foundation. So if you're somebody who has dry skin, or you live in a very dry or cold country, state, anywhere, then you can go for a dewy foundation, because you would not like, you know, get really oily. And demi matte, I think, is something dry skin, oily skin, either of them can go with a really good balance of foundation. So the like the L'Oreal 24 hour fresh wear foundation, that's like a very perfect balance of demi matte. It's not too dewy, it's not too matte, looks really beautiful on the skin. So that is like a very good demi matte finish. Now coming to matte foundations are like, what do you say, matte? I don't know how to explain. So basically you don't see any shine, any dewiness or anything. Ideally good for somebody who has oily skin. So even if it looks really matte when you put on, because you have oily skin, your oils get mixed with that, and your skin kind of, you know, after 2-3 hours does look very normal, doesn't look really matte. So matte foundations usually, I think, end up looking a little more cakier than the other foundations. So you need to be really careful. But I think you understood already, my favorite is a demi matte, and I really like it. Coming to the types, there's like 100 different types of foundation. Now there's BB cream, CC cream. BB cream, CC cream are that very basic everyday type of things. If you don't want to look like really heavy or you know just want to add some blur effect to the skin, then BB and CC cream are really good, very very sheer coverage, just like a tinted moisturizer. So you can add them on your daily routine, and if you have really good skin and you don't want any coverage, you just want something like a hint to add to your face, so that's really good. Then you have cushion foundation, then you have powder foundation, you have stick foundation, and then you have your regular like foundation bottle. So those are the types of foundations. Now the way you choose that depends really on you. It is a trial and error what you like. Few foundations work really well, few foundations don't work really well. That's like a whole different topic. Now application process, I forgot to mention for primer. So primers I usually tend to apply with my hand because I like to prep my skin, like you know, massage everything and get that really good on my skin. But you know, you can use a brush if you're going to do your makeup on somebody else, and you can go in with a brush and not your fingers. Now foundation, again you can apply with a sponge or a brush. I usually prefer a sponge. I think it's usually like how you start off. If you start off with a brush, you will always like a brush. If you start off with a sponge, you always like a sponge. And I'm not going to talk about tools in this video because it'll be like extremely long. So yeah, those are the types of foundation. Now three things you want to keep in mind when you buy a foundation are: how long does it stay without creasing? Now creasing is something of breaking the product. So basically, like if you have a line like under your eye or here, like people have smile lines, etc., right? So if you have like the foundation breaking apart in those lines, then that is actually called creasing. So you have to like find the foundation which gives you the least amount of creases, the foundation which stays really long time, and a foundation which suits your skin type. That is really really important. Now like I said, dry skin can opt for dewy or demi matte, oily skin demi matte and matte, and normal can go either way. It depends on your choice. If you want to look really dewy, then you can go for something which is dewy. If you want to look matte, then you can go for something which is matte. Now when you choose the color of a foundation, it should be your closest match. It has to be like one perfect match to your skin. It's really difficult to get, so I would say you get two foundation, especially if you come from medium to dark or deeper category, because we have like two different skin tones everywhere. So it's really good to have two foundations to play with, one which almost matches, one a little deeper, so that you can mix and match. In the darker areas you can go with the darker foundation, and the lighter areas you can, you know, kind of work with the same one which matches your skin. And there's various number of categories again in shades as well. So there's undertones in foundation. Now not all undertones suit everybody, so there are various different undertones. There's pink undertones, there's yellow undertones, or more like golden undertones than neutral. So how to find your undertone is a whole different topic, but you know, this is like three different categories you need to know when you buy your foundation. Of undertone is really important, because if you're a warm undertone and if you buy a cool tone foundation, it would not look good on your skin at all. Next one is a corrector. So actually you can do a corrector before you apply your foundation or after. That's really up to you. I would prefer to you to do before foundation, so that just that it's easier. Even if you do any mistakes, you can kind of cover it off with your foundation. I'll put a video here of how to color correct. So now color correction is really really subjective, I think that's the word. So not everybody has to color correct. Unless you have really pigmented skin, you don't have to color correct. So it's not a staple thing in everybody's makeup kit. It's something only like if you have certain skin issues you will have to deal with. So now color correction can be like various different types. So there's orange, violet, yellow, green, etc. So orange is usually used to correct darkness. So if you have really discolored like around the mouth, around the eye, then you usually use orange to get rid of the darkness. If you have yellow or lavender, it's usually to treat a dull skin or anything, and green is to avoid redness. So basically green cancels out red, so you don't end up looking really red. But according to me, I think the yellow, violet and green are not some major color corrector issues, like, you know, because these days now we have beautiful, beautiful foundations that kind of take care of those things. But one thing, of course, orange corrector. Now, I personally don't like a bright orange corrector. If in case I have to go in with one, I go with concealer. We are going to talk about a concealer like in the next step. But now I like a concealer. Either it's a concealer or a foundation. You can do either one for color correction. So you need to go with the foundation or concealer, which is a tad bit, maybe a tad bit darker, or even a tad bit which has like red tones in it. So if you have pigmented you know, skin or hyperpigmentation on areas of your skin, then it's really necessary for you to have a product which has a little bit of red undertones to cancel out that, because if you don't do that, then your makeup will end up looking really gray, because the discoloration or the black or the gray discoloration kind of peeps through your foundation and it makes your entire, you know, makeup look really gray, muddy, ashy. You don't want that. So it's really important to have something which is red undertone in your makeup. Now, next one is concealer. Again, in concealer, there's three different types: sheer coverage, medium coverage, full coverage, and there's again finish, dewy, matte, demi matte. Actually, concealer comes in vast variant, and concealer is something a lot of people are confused about, because we live in a world of Instagram and people don't know, like, people use like 100 different types of concealers and people are really confused. So what exactly is a concealer? Concealer is nothing but foundation, but in a more coverage form, if that makes sense. So when you're going with a concealer, it's ideal to go with something medium to full coverage, because of course, like, if you want sheer, you can just use your foundation. So all the things I told like about undertones and everything apply same like foundation. So, but now let's talk about what shade of concealer should you use. Now, people often get confused that you need to use a lighter shade of concealer. Now, because of Instagram, I completely understand that lighter shade of concealer is only used to highlight your face. I'm not talking about the metallic highlight, I'm talking about highlighting your features. So if you want like the center of part of your feature to be more elevated, you want to grab more attention to the center part, then you use a lighter shade of concealer to achieve that. But if you want to cover your blemishes, your acne scarring, your hyperpigmentation or everything, you need to go in with a concealer which matches your exact skin tone. You should not use a concealer which is lighter. That's not how it works. Only the lighter concealer is used where you want to highlight your face and not elsewhere. So that is a concealer. Concealer or foundation is a choice. You can try both and you can understand which one do you really like. Foundation and concealer do have a lot of different finishes in the terms of like color and consistency and longevity and etc. So all the factors which I told for foundation apply here. It should not crease, stay on for longer time, like all the etc. I don't even remember what I told now, but I've been talking already for 30 minutes. I don't know how long this video is going to be. We're still in the fourth step. So if you want to cover your scar, then get a concealer which matches your skin. If you want to highlight your face, then get a concealer which is light up to your skin. If you want to contour or basically get that dimension in your skin, then you get a darker shade of concealer, and that is like the main thing. Let's move on to contouring. And what exactly is contouring? Contouring is basically getting back dimension to your face. So if you look at a person, like basically a normal bare skin, no part of the entire face is not of one color. Some color, like, you know, because of the sun, we do have different shades of like color on the skin. So usually we have like a deeper So usually your forehead is a lot more deeper, or your, like, you know, chin is a lot more deeper. Depends on, you know, how sun hits your face. So when you're using foundation or concealer, what you're doing is you're kind of like, you know, making an entire flat base and getting the entire face to one color. So it ideally doesn't look really nice because you end up looking really pale. There's no color on your face. It's just like a white, I mean not white, like a plain basically mask, which doesn't have any structure. So contouring and blush do add back that color and that dimension back to your face. So contouring is really important. I know a lot of people who don't own a bronzer, like they do, they have foundation, concealer, everything. They'll own like 3-4 highlighters, but they won't have a bronzer. Trust me, contouring, like bronzer, is really important. If you're adding even a slightest bit of concealer or like foundation, I think bronzer is something really, really basic you have to have in your routine. It's a really important step to get back that dimension, or else your makeup is not going to look good at all. Now coming to the types of contouring, so you can do a cream contour or you can do a powder contour. Cream contour is basically you just use like a concealer or a contour stick which you have, which is a deeper, like maybe like 2-3 shades deeper. If you want a very softer look, then 2 shades deeper or like, you know, 3 shades deeper of the concealer is fine. But if you want like really strong, then you can go like 4, but I think 2 is really fine. If you're a beginner, you want a very slight amount of that dimension, then I think 2-3 shades is like really fine. So you can add that, you can blend it out, and like that's like a creamy effect. And there's powder contour, which basically this is like a contour plus bronzer powder. So you can just like directly like powder your face and then you can go in with this. But if you're going to go in with a cream contour, then you need to apply this immediately after you apply your foundation and concealer, not after powder, because powder and again foundation, like the cream, doesn't blend well together. So you need to apply prior to your powder. And now there's tones in contouring as well. So there's cool tone and there's warm tone. So warm tone is something a wider range of people use, because it's just like a warm effect. It gives you that sun-kissed effect to your skin, and it's something very basic. Bronzer is something you can just take on a fluffier brush and just add on the outer parts of your face to get back that dimension to your face. But when you use a cool tone contour, you need to be really careful. It's usually used when you want, like, you know, to get that very carved out features. Of course, there's again skin types. You can use cool toned a lot as well, but most of the time a bronzer is very warm toned. It's a very basic thing to have. Please do get it. The Wet n Wild one is super cheap, really good to use. Or the NYX one is also really good. You can try it out. It looks really nice on the skin. So that's it. Cream contour, powder contour, and again usme there is types, which is warm contouring or cool contouring. Depends on your skin, what you like, how it looks. That's like your call. This one is blush. Again, blush also has two types. One is a cream contour, sorry, cream blush, like the Ruby Organics. This is a cream blush. You apply it again before applying your powder, just because it blends well. Or one more is the powder contour, like this one. So depends on your choice. Now if you have oily skin, then I would ask you to mostly go in with everything powder. Like only concealer and foundation can be your cream products, and the rest, everything can be a powder. It's just like a safer game to play, so that you don't get greasy very quickly. But if in case you have dry skin, you can go with cream products. Cream products look really beautiful when you blend them out well. So if you are a beginner, actually I would ask you to stay away from cream contouring or cream blushing, because they are a little difficult to blend. So you need to have a lot of product practice. Now if it's like a powder, you can easily kind of buff and blend, and they don't look as harsh as a cream product would do. So this is a powder one, this is a cream one. Whichever is your choice, you can go in with that. Cream blush is also really beautiful. Powder blush is also really beautiful. There's again finishes in the blush as well. So there's usually a little bit of shimmery blush there, and there's like a matte blush. Now shimmery blush usually just comes off in like, you know, a powder format. So you have like, this is like a proper matte blush. Now there is a shimmery blush as well, I think it's somewhere. Like, please forgive me if I forget to show you products. I literally am like surrounded with so many products and sitting here. So this is the powder one, and the one other one is like a shimmer one. I usually prefer a matte blush. Looks really beautiful because I can add this like in the center part on my cheeks or everything. It looks really beautiful. I don't like a shimmer blush because it kind of exaggerates my texture. So I'm an acne prone skin person. I do have like acne bumps here and there. Now if I add like a shimmery blush there, it kind of exaggerates the acne a lot more than I want. A matte blush kind of tones it down, doesn't look really bad, just adds the color and looks really beautiful. Now coming to the colors to choose for blush. Now there's 100 million tones to choose from blush, so it can be really, really overwhelming. I'll just point out few things. Of course, it can always vary. I'm just giving you options out there. If you like something which is either way, then that's completely fine. You can keep using it. So if you're a person who's from fair to light or light medium skin tone categories, then you can. I'm just gonna read it out, guys. I'm so tired. I wrote so many things. If you are somebody from light to fair category, you can go in with like baby pinks, you can go in with muted corals or muted orange or salmon pinks or something like that. Look really, really beautiful. They're very toned down, so like, you know, that light color of thing looks really beautiful. Of course, you can go in with deeper shades as well. It's just that it look too strong for your skin type, skin tone. So if you're like, you know, lighter type, then you can go in with really like muted colors. Looks really beautiful on your skin. Now when it comes to medium deep or like anything like that, mauve pinks look really, really beautiful. A really good orange blush also looks really beautiful. A really good orange blush also looks really beautiful on a really good orange blush. So too many really, really happening. So yeah, a good orange blush for a medium skin, a really good coral, all these looks really beautiful for like medium skin tone. And if you go for deep, then there's brownish pinks, beautiful pinks. Actually, I really like them to use for my skin tone as well, but I just use it like on my high points of the face if I really want to. But you know, it's completely fine. Like I told you, it depends on the look you're going for, whatever. So a really good magenta, a really good orange, a really good brownish pink looks really beautiful on deep skin tone. You can of course go in with like pink, like a bright pink as well, but you need to be really careful on what the rest of the face is looking like as well, so that you kind of mute and balance everything, and that will look really nice. So you can do cream contouring and cream blush using a normal like brush or a sponge. It's your choice. But if it's like a powder blush or a powder contour, then you can definitely just use a very like a fluffy brush or whatever your face, according to your face. Now next is powders. Now again, in powders there's various types. So there's loose powder and there's a compact powder. Now loose powder is something like this. It's like basically a loose powder which you use to set your foundation or concealer. Now you always have to set your foundation and concealer because it's a cream product and it tends to move around a lot because there's like, it's really sticky if you touch with your hand, with whatever, it kind of transfers. So the powder helps it like stay on the face for a really long time, and it helps in creasing as well. So this is like a loose powder. Then you have a compact powder, which is basically like a pressed powder, and you even have powder foundations. A lot of people set their face with powder foundations as well. This one is from Maybelline, like, you know. But usually if you want to go with, you know, a really good stick-on base, like something which would not move, would not crease, then loose powder is very ideal. Of course, you can go in with compacts on a daily basis where you add a very little bit of makeup and you just want something to set it, then you can definitely go with this. Sometimes compacts, a lot of compacts have good coverage, so you can just add that as your like normal makeup instead of like a foundation. Also like powder foundation also really works good for that. So those are the different types. Now again, in loose powders there's different types. So there's translucent powder and this colored powder. So basically, translucent powder is a powder which doesn't change color of anything, a foundation or a concealer. If the color doesn't change, it basically just sets it in place. But what happens is when you are like medium or medium deep category, a translucent powder, even though they say it doesn't have any color, it kind of starts looking a little bit, or the, don't mind the orange on it, that's just like my brush constantly. But like, you know, that's like a white powder. Now you need to be really careful with the translucent powder if you have a deeper skin tone, because it will look gray. The white can sometimes end up looking really gray, especially depends on the powder. This Laura Mercier one is like really good, but sometimes this also does give a white cast. Especially Flashback is worst when it comes to translucent powder and medium deep skin categories, so to be really, really careful. Now next one is the colored powder, which is mostly preferred if you're like medium deep. Then you can definitely always go for colored powder. So this Maybelline one is a colored powder, but the only con is it does change the foundation and concealer color. So if you have a foundation or like concealer which suits really beautifully for your skin, but if you have a powder which is a little deeper, a little lighter, the problem is it does like tend to change the color of that, which That's the reason I don't like most of the colored ones, but you know, that's like the best way to avoid that gray flashback. So you can, you know, kind of mix and play if you want, or else you can go with a colored powder which has less coverage. So usually what happens is their colored powders do have a little bit of coverage as well, especially this Maybelline one. So like this K Beauty one is also a colored powder, but it doesn't give as much is coverage as the Maybelline one. So even if you use this to set your foundation or anything, it won't entirely change the color of the entire foundation, because it doesn't have so much strength to change the colors, doesn't have so much coverage. It'll just like, you know, lightly brush off everything and look really nice. It does have a tiny bit of coverage, but you can, you know, just brush it off to just set the foundation and so that it doesn't move. So powders do depend on skin type as well. Now this Laura Mercier one is like a very proper matte foundation, not foundation, powder. So if you set it, it's gonna stay. You're not going to get greasy for a very long time. Whereas the Maybelline one, I would like, you know, prefer if you have dry skin. So it is a really good powder. It's just that if you have oily skin, you would get oily a little quicker if you use this compared to this. If this keeps you matte for like 8 hours, this will keep you matte for like 5.5 hours. Basically matte matlab you don't have any oiliness or greasiness. That's basically what I mean by matte. Usually the place I only tend to avoid grease is this, because when here I start getting greasy, here my cheeks start looking very weird and I get a lot of volume, which unwanted attention there, which I don't really like. There's a little powder on that which came. So for powder under the eye, I usually tend to go in with a sponge, and for the rest of the face, I do go in with the brush, and then I just like dust off the powder lightly on the entire face. So I'm going to end this first part right here. So until then, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell so that you get notified whenever I post the second part. I hope this video is being useful. So, but yeah, until then, enjoy this video and wait for my next video. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!